Hi, I'm Julio Barros from eString.com, and I want to give you a super quick overview of Xcode 4 by taking you through building a Hello World type application. We'll do it really quickly, and you can always stop and rewind the video if you like. Also, a transcript of the code is available on my website at eString.com. So the idea is that when we start the app, it shows us a message. When we press the button, the message changes. It's really simple, but uses core techniques that we need to master and gives us a project to work with in Xcode 4. So let's start. When Xcode 4 comes up, go ahead and create a new project. Make it a view-based application and call it Fortune, because it'll tell our fortune and we can put it in the App Store and make a fortune. I'm leaving the unit tests and Git repository boxes checked, but we'll wait to talk about them till another video. You can save the project any place you'd like. The big thing you'll notice is that Xcode 4 and Interface Builder are now all one app and live in one window with multiple panes. Call me a nerd, but I like to run my project right away. I love seeing a new app pop up in the simulator and it verifies that everything is set up correctly. On the left-hand side, we have the Navigator pane, and on the right, the Editor pane. Xcode is showing us details on the project itself since we have the project file selected in the source tree. I have some icons handy, so I'll just add them to the project. I want the files copied into my project directory, so I'll make sure the Copy checkbox is selected. As we click on different files, such as the app delegate, the editor shows us the contents of that file. And when we click on a nib, or zib if you like, we see Interface Builder right in Xcode. We can bring up the library in the far right-hand side with the utility button on top. From here, we can drag out a label and add it to our view. I can change its size and position and adjust its properties in the inspector pane. We can save and run, and now we have a label in our app. Now, to change it programmatically, we'll need a reference to it in our code. We do this by tagging an instance variable with IBOutlet and hooking it up in Interface Builder. We used to have to write that first and then bounce back and forth between Xcode and Interface Builder, but we can now bring up the source and graphical editor in the same window. We can control drag from the graphical builder to the code, and Xcode will add our instance variable already tagged. I can now go to my implementation file and change the label text wherever it makes sense. I'll do it in the viewDidLoad. I'll also add a release to the dialloc, which is now at the top of the file. And now when I build and run, I see the message as updated in code instead of what was originally in the nib. We can go back and adjust it so it looks better, make it taller, and tell it to use multiple lines and run it again. Another key building block is hooking up actions. Let's drag out a button from the library. Change the button to say something like, "What's in my future?" And to hook it up to our code, we bring up the interface file in the editor and control drag to below the IVAR section. This lets us set a method that will act as our action with the IB action tag. I'll call my action the obvious button pushed. We can go to the implementation file and fill in the method we just defined. And when we build and run, we can see the label changes when the button is pushed. That's the basic of the application, but I can't help jazzing it up a bit. Every Fortune app needs to have a little magic in it, so in my action, I'll set the alpha to 0 so the label disappears, change the text, and then in an implicit animation block, I'll bring the alpha back up to 1 so it fades in over a period of 2 seconds. Now that's pretty slick, and I totally believe our fortunes are in Xcode 4. You'll do variations of these basic tasks in every app you build, so to get comfortable with IB outlets and IB actions, I suggest you practice it over and over again and watch the video as many times as needed. I hope this simple app has served as a quick introduction to Xcode 4 and you found this video helpful. For the source code and more in-depth information, please go to eString.com. And if you'd like to be notified when new tutorials are available, please sign up for the mailing list. Thanks.